Why, bad times at the El Royale may require more than one viewing. Hi, I'm Seth. Welcome to the review. Nice to see you. Today we're going to review Bad Times at the El Royale. I was really excited for Bad Times at the El Royale because I wanted to see all the characters bounce off one another. It stars Chris Hemsworth, Dakota Johnson, John Hamm, and Jeff Bridges, among other people. It was written and directed by Drew Goddard, who's known for Cabin in the Woods and The Martian. His whole thing is he likes to see different characters bounce off one another because that's how you can gauge what people are actually like. I came into this film thinking it's like The Shining. It's the place that makes it special. And what led me to believe this is that this hotel is based off an actual hotel called the Kill Never. It's half in California and half in Nevada, and it makes me think of Purgatory. I also thought it was a film version of the Eagles Hotel California. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave. Because like it or not, this is a whodunit with some great performances, even though it's slow at times and it seems to be constantly rewinding itself. The rewinding aspect is the first thing that makes it more fun on the second viewing. It's kind of like a Tarantino film, like Pulp Fiction, or maybe closer to Reservoir Dogs. The style of structure can be confusing because you seem to be starting over and over again, and that's what I hate about Vantage Point when it came out in 2008. The second reason why it's a better movie that second time around is that the script is in viewer omniscience. That's a fancy way of saying that you know more than the characters do when they're running around in their little boxes. It's like watching an episode of Friends. You know, Rachel and Ross are going to whine about getting their way. Chandler and Monica are obsessed by their insecurities. Joey and Phoebe are dim. Although Phoebe might not be as dim as she seems. You know what's going to happen, and you're just here to see how the sitcom plays out. That brings me to my third point. Everything is just for show. You've seen the trailer where John Hamm is a voyeur. Well, that's what this movie is about. Everything's a show and nothing is real. This is a common plotline in hotel movies. For instance, Norman Bates was and wasn't what he appeared to be in Psycho. He was a taxidermist. He wanted a bunch of toys. He was in charge. He decided who lived and who died. My final thought is that Drew Goddard has a real message here, and it has something to do with the title. We've all seen crime films about the good old days, like Goodfellas and The Untouchables. These films make it sound like it was better then than it is now. Only it wasn't. Bad Times showcases bank robbers and G-men, hippies and killers, all holding up at a hotel in 1969. And I'm not talking specifically about the Me Too movement or anything like that. I'm talking about how it was a time when people assumed society was safe and it wasn't. Kids were snatched up by pedophiles off the street and were never seen again. Lake and Mystic River, Charles Manson actively recruited girls to kill for him. His victims included actress Sharon Tate. One of his would-be victims was President Gerald Ford in 1975. No, the good old days were the bad old days. But you can view them again and again safely from the comfort of your seat. In Bad Times at the El Royale. If you like this film, click like, subscribe, ring my bell for notifications, visit my links in the comment box below, and I really thank you for coming to see me. It means a lot to me, and I'll see you in the next one.